Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. Am I audible? Okay, poverty. Today we will start the next chapter as a poverty, as a challenge. Poverty as challenge. Poverty, it is a situation in which a person unable to complete their basic needs. When a person unable to complete their basic needs, that state is known as the poverty. That situation is known as poverty. When a person unable to complete their basic necessities as per available resources within a country, that situation is known as the poverty. Basic needs like food, shelter, clothing. Food, shelter, and clothing. When a person unable to complete their basic needs, food, shelter, and clothing is known as the poverty. It is known as the poverty. When a larger section of population in an economy deprived to get minimum necessities is known as the mass poverty. When a larger section of population deprived to complete their basic necessities is known as the mass poverty. Mass poverty. After completion of 70 years of Indian independence, still 27 to 29% people are still under the poverty. They are still under the poverty. They are categorized under that group which can't complete their basic necessities. Basic necessities. And the reason of this as the less number of job opportunities as per the existing population. As an increase in population, job opportunities are not increasing. Job opportunities are not increasing, which leads to the not complete as the basic necessities of people. That's why there is the last section of a population, 29% of a population still living under poverty. They are still living under poverty. At the time of independence in 1947, 60% of a total population living under the, at that time it was under the poverty. After completion of 70 years of Indian independence, still as a such section of a population under poverty, below poverty line. For estimation of a poverty, the status of a poverty in a country, for which as we are following as a poverty line. Poverty line. But before of it, there are two types of the poverties are there. Types of poverty, relative poverty and absolute poverty. Relative poverty and absolute poverty. Two types of the poverty are there. Relative poverty, absolute poverty. Absolute poverty. Absolute poverty. Relative poverty and absolute poverty. Relative poverty and absolute poverty. Relative poverty refers to the economic conditions of relative poverty refers to economic conditions of different regions, economic conditions of different regions or countries, different regions in the sense continents, such parts which are covering as a vast extensive area. It may be as a continent or either as a southern parts of a continent, southern, eastern, western, northern parts of a continent. Regions or countries, different economic conditions present in a different regions or countries in relation to per capita income and national income. Yes, anybody? What it means as a per capita income? How can we calculate the per capita income? Yes, anybody? Tell me about how can we calculate the per capita income. 9th A class, how can we calculate per capita income? Per capita income is a average income. Per capita income is a average income. We calculate the average as a sum of a total observations divided by the total number of observations. Very good, Lakshyarat. It's the per capita income is earned by the individuals. Earned by all the individuals. We can calculate the per capita income, total income divided by the total income in the sense income which has generated to the, which has earned to the primary sector, secondary sector, tertiary sector. Three sectors of Indian economy. Total income earned from three sectors of Indian economy divided by the total population. It means you are also constitutes under the per capita income. Presently, you are not contributing. Very good, Hiren. Total income divided by the population. Total income divided by total population through which as a we can calculate as a per capita income. Average income. Sum of the observations. Observations are income which has earned from the three sectors divided by the total population through which we can calculate per capita income. So per capita income as a criteria, as an indicator used to check the poverty trends in the country. Those economies where the per capita income is a lesser in the sense for which as a World Bank, it was given as a classification of a world economies. World Bank divided the world economies into the three categories on the basis of a per capita income. World Bank divided the world economies into the three categories: developed nations, developed economies, developed countries, developing countries, and third as underdeveloped countries. Now, for which as a World Bank use as a criteria, per capita income. Those countries which are having as a annual per capita income more than 435,500. 435,500. More than 435,500 are the developed countries like US, like Canada. China has categorized under the developed nations. Japan, Russia. These are the countries where the per capita income annually means the average person earns more than 435,500. More than 435,500. Clear? These countries are those where the poverty has not existed. Unemployment is not there. That's why the large number of the workforce moving from the poorer countries towards the such countries, Canada, Australia, Japan, for the better living conditions for their earnings. They are moving towards the such countries. Clear? Second are developing countries. Those economies which now at present improving their status. Improving their status, they are eradicating their problems like as under unemployment, poverty, such kind of the problems they eradicating through their efforts are the developing nations. They are possessing as a per capita income 35,500 to 4,35,500. 4,35,500. These are developing nations. Developing nations, Sri Lanka, African countries are categorized under the developing nations. Clear? And third category is underdeveloped economies. Those economies which are having as a low per capita income, less than 35,500. Less than 35,500 are the underdeveloped nations. India lies under it. Because in our country, the annual per capita income is the 27,000 approximately. 27,000 rupees. These figures are in rupees. 27,000. It means India has rise under the underdeveloped nations. It's due to the large scale of the population. India's total 130 crore of the population, 130 crores of population, in which a large section near about 40 crores of population is still living under the poverty. Still living under poverty. Clear? Relative poverty, clear? Relative poverty, it is as a dead state of a economy in which we study the trends of different countries in relation to the per capita income and national income. How can we calculate the national income? How can we calculate the national income? Yes, anybody? 9th A. It's done for a girl. How can we calculate the national income? Yes, 9th A. How can we calculate national income?
Sir, it is the sum that a country produces in a financial year. Goods and services that a country provides.
Okay, good. But that is a GDP. All those goods and services, their sum value is known as a sum value of a goods and services. Sum of the value of a goods and services produced within a country in a fixed period of time. It may be a year, is known as a GDP. When you are adding the earned income from the abroad, means those are the parents of a children which are moving towards abroad, those individuals which are moving towards abroad for the better earnings, but they spending their money on their families which are now as living in our country. Clear? National income as calculated to as the income earned from primary, secondary, tertiary plus income earned from abroad. Their collective value is known as a national income. Clear? The sum value of a primary, secondary and tertiary is a GDP. When we add the income earned from the abroad plus income earned from abroad plus GDP is known as a national income. So those economies where the per capita income and national income use as criteria to study the trends of the poverty is known as a relative poverty. It is known as the relative poverty. Yes, still there any questions? Relative poverty, when we study about the economic conditions of different regions or countries of world in relation to per capita income and national income, is known as the relative poverty. It is known as the relative poverty. Any questions, any queries still there? Then we proceed towards as absolute poverty. Per capita income is the average income earned by all individuals. Average income earned by the all individuals. Total income earned from a three sectors divided by the total population. Total income divided by the total population is known as the per capita income or average income. I'm again repeating as a from beginning. Poverty is a situation, just pay attention. Poverty is a situation in which a person unable to complete their basic needs. When such poverty trends are lies in a larger population, a large section of a population can't complete their basic requirements like food, shelter, and clothing. That is known as the mass poverty. Clear? Poverty has their two types, two forms, relative poverty, absolute poverty. Relative poverty means when we study about the economic conditions of a different countries or different regions of a world in relation to per capita income and national income is known as relative poverty. It is known as relative poverty. Per capita income means the average income earned by every individual. World Bank divided the world economies based upon a per capita income as a criteria. Developed countries are those which are having as a 435,500 more than of its as a per capita income. These are the developed countries like United States of America, Canada, Australia, Japan, Russia, China. These are the developed nations. England, France are the developed nations. Why? Because poverty is not existed in such economies. Unemployment is not existing. Such economies are the economically prosperous. Developing are those nations which are now as improving their standard, which are now as improving. For example, as a Sri Lanka, Nepal, which are as now improving their standards at present, which are possessing as a 35,500 to the 435,500 in rupees. These figures are in rupees as their per capita income annually. And underdeveloped, those economies which possess as a less than 35,500 as annual income. If we use this criteria, India lies under the underdeveloped nations. But when we're talking about the health, the standard of the health, standard of education, sanitation, clean drinking water, means of transport, then India lies in a developing nations. It is improving. Both India and Pakistan, they declared independent on the same time on 1947. After the completion of more than 70 years of Indian independence, still as Pakistan lies in underdeveloped. Why? Because it has depending upon other nations for its economic conditions. But India is a self-reliant to improve their conditions. According to the World Bank, India is rising in a underdeveloped. If we use the other criteria like health, education, when we see the status of these things, then India has lies in a developing nations. Developing nations. India lies in a developing nations. If we exclude only that particular indicator, except the per capita income, when we're talking about the other kinds of changes occur in economy. Foreigners are moving towards India for the better and the cheaper medical facilities. Medical tourism, which you read in a 7th standard. Medical tourism. In our country, as a health facilities are the cheaper. So in that relation, India is a developing. Why? Because at the time of independence, 60% people were under poverty. But now as a trend has decreased, as around 29% people are still under living and under the poverty. Means changes are occurred in our economy. Changes occurred in our economy. Clear? Is that clear, Jasleen? So let's proceed towards the next, absolute poverty. absolute poverty. Till there, any questions? Till there, any questions? Yes, any questions? Next is absolute poverty. Absolute poverty. Absolute poverty refers to absolute poverty refers to the measure of poverty refers to the measure of poverty keeping in view the per capita income intake of calories consumption means a minimum requirement of a calories which is required by the every person for its normal growth, for his or her normal growth, for which as a criteria has used 2400 calories are desired by a person in rural economy. If a person has living in a rural economy in a village area, it has required the 2400 calories in a day. 2400 calories in a day. 2400 calories in a day. And if a person living in a urban area, like as a Jalandhar, it require as 2100 calories. 2100 calories. 2100 calories. That absolute poverty refers to the measure of poverty keeping in view the per capita intake of calories, per capita intake of calories to satisfy their needs. Minimum as a 2400 calories in a rural areas, 2400 calories in rural areas and 2100 calories in urban areas desired by every person in living in a different economies. Why? Because in rural economy, people are generally engaged in a manual work. But in urban economies, physical work is a lesser comparatively to villages. That's why as a people are required as a 2100 calories. 2100 calories. Clear? If a person can't complete their 2100 calories in a Jalandhar, in a urban areas, means the person has living under the poverty. Under calories in a day. Kamanu Singh, not taking as the average figure as 2400 calories in a rural economy and 2100 calories in urban areas. Clear? This is as absolute poverty, through which we can check that a person is above poverty or below poverty. To check about poverty, for which as a to estimation of a poverty, we use two methods used to estimate poverty are expenditure method means how much you spending on a completion of your basic needs, food, shelter and clothing. Expenditure method and income method. Yes, still there any questions? Then afterwards we will start as a estimation. How can we calculate as the poverty in our country? Yes, any questions? Expenditure method and income method. Expenditure method. So expenditure method, no doubts. So let's see, proceed. Expenditure method means total amount of money which is spending on a completion of a basic needs. Money which is spending on a completion of a basic needs. It is known as the expenditure method. Expenditure method. Let's take as a one of the example. Example. How many number of goods which are used by the Akhilesh in their day-to-day life? In their day-to-day life. What kind of materials? For example, in a day, Akhilesh used as a 12 chapatis, 3 glasses of milk, 3 glasses of milk, 2 bowls of porridge, 250 grams of vegetables or pulses. So such kind of materials used by the Akhilesh in their day-to-day life. First of all, we have to check about the total number of food items. We have to know about the what type of the items are used by the individual in their day-to-day life to satisfying their need of food. We have to calculate the number of such items into the calories. For example, the 12 chapatis used by the Akhilesh in their daily life. If the each chapati has consisting the 70 calories, 70 into 12, 840 calories over. Remaining as a Akhilesh living in a urban area, 2100 calories. We have to reach 2100 calories as a desirable for a Akhilesh for the normal growth. Normal growth. Clear? So 840 completed through as a chapatis, 3 glasses of milk used by the Akhilesh in their daily life. If the each glass of milk consisting of the 120 calories, 360 calories, means 360 calories are complete through as the 3 glasses of milk. Average size of 250 milliliters of milk glass, 360 calories. 840 through the chapatis, 360 through the milk. Total number it will be as a 1200. Very good, Dhiren. 1200. Remaining as a 900 calories. 2 bowls of porridge. Each bowl consisting of the 250 calories. Porridge. Then the 1200 plus 500, 1700. 1700. Remaining as a 400, which are out of which as a 200 completed to as a vegetables. 250 grams of a vegetable or a pulses used by the Akhilesh in their daily life. First of all, we have to identify the number of goods used by the individual. Second, we have to convert the or we calculate as the calories, the total number of calories intake by the individual from a such number of goods. Now, as a 1700 plus 200, 1900 means the adequate diet not taken by the Akhilesh in their daily life. In their daily life. Clear? First of all, calculate the number of goods taken by the person in their daily life. Second, as converted into the caloric value, their caloric value. Third, how much money you are spending, because the method is expenditure. How much money spending on a purchasing of such materials? 12 chapatis ke liye kitna kharcha ho raha hai? Total expenditure, total money which is spending by the Akhilesh in their daily life for purchasing of such materials, their value we have to calculate. One thing. Second thing, we have to check about the how much expenses required by the Akhilesh for their completion of a clothing needs. Here we are not talking about a branded clothes, the basic cloth items, their prices. Third, as the for their survival, for their living conditions, as a for example expenses on electricity electricity, water, for a transport, for a resident, maybe as Akhilesh living on a rented apartment, their value. So food, shelter, clothing, total expenditure which is spent upon these three basic necessities, and then the one figure it will be as a come out. If that figure as the annual basis as 20, less than the 27,000, less than 2740. If that figure of annual basis comes as above our 27,000, then the person is living as above poverty line. Clear? This is as a one way through which we can check about the poverty in a country. We can check about the standard of a poverty in a country. Expenditure method. First of all, identify or calculate those number of goods taken by a person to satisfy their need of a food. Second, converted the value of such food items into their calorie value. Third, we have to calculate the total expenditure, total money which is spending by that individual on purchasing of such goods. Fourth, we have to calculate about those number of that money which is spending by that individual on clothing, on a rented apartment for completion of their basic needs, different number of needs, what kind of the services are availed by them. So total expenditure, total spending money has calculated on an annual basis through which we can calculate as a standard of a poverty in a country. Standard of poverty in a country. Clear? Standard of poverty in a country. Till there any questions? Expenditure method. Tomorrow we will discuss. We will start from the income method. Yes? Expenditure method. Any questions? Any questions related with the expenditure method? Yes? Anybody want to ask any question related with the expenditure method? Expenditure method. In relation to the income method, there are different definitions which are known in all over the world. Planning Commission. What we now as presently call to the Planning Commission. Roll number 39. 39 roll number, raise your hand. Roll number 39, raise your hand. 42, 39, 42, 26, 26, 26, I think it's a Patharia, Mitansh Patharia. Yes, 26. Mitansh, are you there? Very good. Dhiren and Laksh given correct answer. Niti Aayog. Dhiren and Laksh Jairath given. So Niti Aayog, in 2014, the name of a planning commission changed as a Niti Aayog. Planning commission, which was set up on 1950. Afterwards, the government of India planned for a sectoral growth of economy. So that planning commission given as a definition of a poverty as a person which is spending 32 rupees in a day. 32 rupees in a day. That person is considered as above poverty. 32 rupees in a day. This is as a definition given by the Planning Commission in India. But the World Bank given as a definition of a poverty as a person spending $1 in a day is considered as above poverty. Person spending the $1 in a day, it is considered as above poverty. Clear? Yes, any questions?